Hi everyone. If you like what we're doing, please like, comment, and subscribe. Our goal is 1,000 subscribers by this summer. And we plan on sharing our live egg cuttings of our hognose, corn snake, and bull snake clutches. In today's video, we'll be talking about three different styles of rodent breeding. The first is colony breeding for the large-scale breeder who produces thousands of rats a week, up to or down to someone who produces several hundred rats a week and has the space for this style breeding. Some hobbyists follow this, but mostly it is large-scale production. The second topic we'll cover is colony breeding for the hobbyist breeder. In this, it doesn't really make sense for the large-scale breeder, and it is best for the hobbyist who has a minimum amount of space or only has 1 to 2 racks of rats. There are a few constants that need to be understood, and that is female rats produce on average between 8 and 12 pinkies per litter, and when production drops below 8 pinkies, the female needs to be replaced, and this is a factor that sets in with any rodent production. And all females take roughly 21 days of gestation to produce pinkies after being impregnated. Our first topic is large-scale colony breeding. It consists of one male in every tub, along with 3 to 4 females per tub with those males. And in this setup, the males are placed with the females and left to breed. They are not interrupted except for cleaning and for pulling of whatever size rats are needed. In a large scale setup, this works out very well because it allows for rats of all sizes to be available at all times, because with multiple racks, you know, 10 plus, 6 plus, somewhere in that range, you end up with an offset in when your females produce, and you will have the size you need available at all times. Now, the downside to this, in a small setup of 1 to 2 racks, you will end up with surges in output. And the reason why is it's very hard to get males alternating with each other to have output all the time. And on top of that, with only 1 to 2 racks, you're going to end up going through a lot more food, as males eat a lot more food than females. And on top of this, it is very easy to miss females that whose production drops below 8. You end up having to go on the average output of the entire tub, which means you could have one female producing 4 to 6 pinkies and then having the other two females producing 11 and 8, and you will end up with a less than optimum setup where you're replacing 3 females instead of just the one or two females that are producing less, and end up losing out on that female by having to freeze her off. For our second style of rodent breeding, we're going for the hobbyist version of colony breeding, and this requires 1 to 2 racks of 5 to 6 tubs and one male per rack and 3 to 4 females per tub in those racks. So you end up with a ratio of roughly one male to every 15 to 18 females. And the way this works is that you start with your male in the very top bin, and every 1.5 to 2 weeks, you will move that male down a bin. And what this does is it allows the females in the top bin every 1 to 1.5 weeks after the male moves to have their babies, not be disturbed by the male. They'll help each other, and you will have pinkies while the other females are still waiting to be impregnated. 1.5 to 2 weeks later, the male has moved again, which means the top tub has now had their babies laid. The second tub has been impregnated, and the third tub is now being impregnated. You'll then move the male down again 1.5 to 2 weeks later, in which case your top tub has weaned two small rats in it. Your middle tub, or your second tub, has pinkies in it, and your third tub has now been impregnated. Your fourth tub is being impregnated, and 1.5 to 2 weeks later, at this point, you should be pulling the babies from the top tub, as there should be smalls to mediums. Your next tub down, the second tub, should be weaned to smalls. Your third tub down should now be have their pinkies. Your fourth tub should be impregnated, and now your fifth tub should be being impregnated. And at this point, if you are in a five tub rack, 1.5 to 2 weeks later, your females at the top of the rack have now had a 2 week break from your male. You then move that male from the bottom of the rack up to the top again. Or if you're in a 12 week system, you move that the male down one more time, giving an extra 2 weeks to the females on top, and you'll be pulling rats consistently. Now, again, the downside to this is that it's very easy to miss females whose production is falling off, and you'll end up replacing all of the females in a tub at one time just to be safe, to make sure that you don't lose production. Now, the upside to this, though, is that you have a consistent, reliable output so long as the females are replaced that you can depend on for feeding for one rack with an average output of 10 per female. If you have three females per tub, that is roughly 30 rats per rack every week, every 2 weeks that you can depend on. In reality, it's not 30. It's a little less than that. But feeding one rack of snakes for a 50-pound bag, you'll go through a 50-pound bag in every 2 to 3 weeks, if not longer. It becomes very affordable compared to buying your rats. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Again, please remember to subscribe and ring that notification bell. Tomorrow, we'll be going over heritage or maternity style rodent breeding with all of its details and optimizations for small spaces. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.